Good morning, guys. Who here has ever heard of What Would Jesus Do bracelets? Well, I don't have a bracelet today, but I do have a class ring with WWJD engraved on the side of it. And it serves to me as a daily reminder to walk in the steps of Jesus Christ and to take his wisdom into every situation. Though I've never seen a What Would a Pharisee Do bracelet, I don't think there should be. Jesus' biggest message against the Pharisees was the Sermon on the Mount. And I believe that one of the most overlooked messages in the Sermon on the Mount is Matthew chapter 7, verses 13 and 14. It says, "Enter through the narrow gate, because the gate is wide and the way is spacious that leads to destruction. But there are many who enter it. How narrow is the gate and difficult the way that leads to life, and there are few who find it." So, in this passage, we are told about two paths, with one leading us to our eternal demise and being very difficult, or very easy to travel, and the other being treacherous to take that leads you to eternal righteousness. But I have found that oftentimes through life, there are many times when these two paths can seem to run parallel with each other. So, how can we decipher which path will lead you to righteousness to escape your destruction? Well, in Philippians 2, 5-11, it says, "You should have the same attitude towards one another that Christ Jesus had, who though he existed in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking on the form of a slave, by looking like other men, and by sharing in human nature. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, and even death on a cross. As a result, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, in heaven, on earth, and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father." So, Jesus Christ came down to earth from his home in heaven to live among us. While he was here, he walked the difficult path of righteousness to show us how. For we as Christians are called to follow him in his steps. Jesus mentions several ways to walk the narrow path with him and to keep from the broad path that is constantly being trampled underfoot by the Pharisees. Instead of serving God for the satisfaction of the people around us, we need to serve God for the pleasure of God and God alone, because love is not proud. Love requires humility. We also need to keep from forming attachments to the treasures of this earth. This means to be fully willing to give up anything you own to better serve the Lord. It is essential that we are very careful not to condemn one another for our mistakes, but we must also be very careful not to ignore each other's mistakes. For a loving critique to each other will make us a lot stronger against making the same mistake again. Alongside that, we also need to be willing to accept correction when critiqued with love. We must not hold grudges against each other out of hate. It does not matter what your neighbor does against you, you have to find it in your heart to forgive them. We've all heard the verse in Matthew chapter 16, verse 15 that states, "But if you do not forgive others, your Father will not forgive you your sins." It is impossible to walk steadily along the narrow path if we lust after one another, because whoever lusts after their neighbor has already committed lechery in their heart. And there are a few scenarios that make walking the narrow path harder. Say your mom tells you that you have to finish your homework before you can play video games, but you get home a few hours before her after school. Will you have the integrity to honor her command? Or will you take advantage of her absence just to crank a few 90s? Or imagine your friend tells you a hilarious joke that they made, and you share it with your other friend. And after they've had a good laugh, they ask, "Did you come up with that yourself?" Are you going to steal the credit from your friend? And what if they weren't your friend? Would your answer change? On a more serious note, say your sister gets hit by a drunk driver. Will you have the courage as a Christian to forgive the driver? Or will you hate them for their mistake like the rest of the world would? Christianity isn't about having an exact answer for every situation. Christianity is about our love for Jesus Christ and our willingness to follow in his steps. Matthew 7, verses 13 and 14 says, "Enter through the narrow gate, because the gate is wide and the way is spacious that leads to destruction. And there are many who enter through it. How narrow is the gate and difficult the way that leads to life, and there are few who find it." Jesus is asking us to swim upstream against society. Being a follower of Christ isn't easy. In fact, if you consider yourself a Christian and you are able to say that being a Christian is easy, then you're doing it wrong. I'm going to leave you with this. Which gate will you go through? What bracelet are you wearing?